Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in the previous session I have started discussing about surface chemistry. There we considered a concept called adsorption. Okay, yes, I have discussed about adsorption phenomenon, the components involved in it, that is adsorbate and adsorbent. We defined it. Then again I considered desorption phenomenon, that is opposite of adsorption. Okay, it is the process of removal of adsorbates from the surface of a adsorbent. Yes, then thereafter I considered active centers, that is cause for adsorption. Then even we considered thermodynamic parameters, enthalpy, entropy and free energy change during adsorption phenomenon. These three quantities are going to remain negative. Okay, those values will be negative. Then further I considered the differences between adsorption and absorption, right? Well, now in this session we are going to deal about the continuous part, that is types of adsorption. Since we considered adsorption phenomenon, now we are looking for types of adsorption. As we said here, as adsorption takes place between two components, what are those? Adsorbate and adsorbent. Iga adsorbate andre eno? Adsorbate, the substances which are accumulated or concentrated on the surface of solid or liquid are called adsorbate. How the further adsorbent andre en helidivi now, the substances, the surface on which particles are accumulates are called adsorbent, or else in another way what we can say, the substances which gives the surface area for adsorption are called adsorbent. Now here during adsorption what happens? Yes, these two components must interact, these two type of particles must interact with one another so that a phenomenon called adsorption takes place. Andre ee adsorbate matte adsorbent enagbeku, they have to interact with one another. Okay, there will be interaction between interface of these two particles, adsorbate and adsorbent. Now interaction means, yes, they used to interact either with the help of van der Waals forces of attraction, or else they even going to interact by making a chemical bond. It means now here types of adsorption, what is the basis for this classification, means here based on the type of forces, based on the type of force exist between adsorbate and adsorbent, these adsorption can be categorized into two types. Andre illi en yavudra adara, what is the basis for this classification, means based on the type of forces operating or exist between adsorbate and adsorbent. Yes, if I consider types of adsorption, there are mainly two types of adsorption of a gas on a solid. General agi nanu helthivi adsorption ta consider madidre, yes, there are two types of adsorption present. Yes, adsorption can be classified into how many types? Two types. What are those? First one is called physisorption. First one yavudu? Physisorption anta helthivi, or else even it is called physical adsorption. And second type is chemisorption. This chemisorption is also considered or named as a chemical adsorption. Then pettukondi, if I consider types of adsorption, how many types? Yes, there are two types. What are those? Physisorption and chemisorption. Physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. Well, first one, physical adsorption, or I can say physisorption. In the physisorption, andre, as I said, based on the type of forces operating, the adsorption is classified. Well, coming to the first one, physisorption. Okay, well, what is physisorption? If accumulation of gas, if accumulation of gas on the surface of a solid occurs on account of which force? Weak van der Waals forces. Andre here gas is adsorbate. How the gas is endu adsorbate, the solid surface, that is solid as a adsorbent. So gas act as adsorbate Okay, then what about solid surface? Here solid act as a adsorbent, right? So here your gases are adsorbed on the surface of a solid by means of which force? By means of weak van der Waals forces of attraction. Andre ig nanu yavado ond solid, say it is a solid surface, on the surface of which say gaseous molecules are adsorbed. Gas molecules enagutade aa surface mele adsorb agide anta consider madona. Say the, if I consider the force operating in between these two particles, say what type of force? If that force is weak van der Waals force, if gas is adsorbed on account of weak van der Waals forces of attraction, then such a type of adsorption is called physical adsorption or physisorption. Well, I repeat the definition, what it says. Okay, physisorption, if accumulation of gas on the surface of a solid, on surface of a solid is on account of, on surface of a solid occurs on account of which forces? Weak van der Waals forces. If accumulation of gas on surface of a solid occurs on account of weak van der Waals forces, the adsorption is termed as physical adsorption or physisorption. Okay, so in another way, how I can say the phenomenon in which, okay, adsorbates are held on the surface of a adsorbent by means of weak van der Waals forces is called physical adsorption or physisorption. Well, on the other hand, if I consider chemisorption or chemical adsorption, if chemical adsorption andre enilli, then that force must be different, or force of attraction will be different here. Says what it is, when the gas molecules or atoms are held to the solid surface by means of chemical bond. Illenide here gas molecules or atoms are held on a solid surface by means of chemical forces of attraction. What is that chemical force? That is chemical bond. Chemical bond andre yavudu? It may be ionic bond or even it is covalent bond. Then such type of adsorption is called chemical adsorption, or I can say chemisorption. Then particularly physical adsorption alli what type of forces present? It is the weak van der Waals force of attraction. A weak van der Waals forces exist between adsorbate and adsorbent. Now here in chemisorption, or I can say chemical adsorption, what type of forces present? A strong chemical bond exist. What that bond? It may be ionic bond or a covalent bond. A strong chemical force of attraction exists between adsorbate and adsorbent, or else I can say a strong either ionic or covalent bond exists between adsorbate and adsorbent, results into what type of adsorption? Chemical adsorption. Okay, well, it's regarding types of adsorption. Yes, how many types are there? Two types. One is physical adsorption, second one is chemical adsorption. Okay, well, now if I consider chemical adsorption or chemisorption, say it involves high activation energy. Iga nanu if I consider the features of this chemical adsorption regarding physical, opposite of this, the chemical adsorption involves high activation energy. Then what about physical adsorption? It do not require any activation energy. Okay, only for chemical adsorption, since it involves a bond formation, therefore here it involves a high energy of activation and is therefore often referred as activated adsorption. Okay, so here chemical adsorption requires certain activation energy, therefore the chemical adsorption is also called activated adsorption. Okay, remember the name, activated adsorption. Okay, well, now coming to the differences between physisorption and chemisorption. Okay, physical adsorption and chemical adsorption, how they actually differ from one another. Okay, yes, when I look at the definition, yes, we can say physical adsorption, a type of adsorption in which adsorbate and adsorbents are held together by means of which forces? Van der Waals forces of attraction. On the other hand, chemical adsorption, it is a type of adsorption in which adsorbate and adsorbent are held together by means of chemical bond, either ionic or covalent bond. Well, when you look at the differences, say the first one, first point of difference, what I can say, it rises because of van der Waals forces. Okay, the chemical adsorption anta heladre en helthivi now, it rises because of van der Waals forces of attraction. On the other hand, chemical adsorption ellenide, it is caused by chemical bond formation. Andre physisorption, it is due to van der Waals forces of attraction, while chemisorption is because of chemical bond formation. Andre illi one difference ide, one type of difference. So it is the first point of difference, physisorption, it rises because of van der Waals forces, while chemisorption, it is caused by chemical bond formation. Okay, well, coming to the second difference, enalutte physical adsorption is not specific in nature. Andre illi physical adsorption takes place between any kind of adsorbate and adsorbent. Remember, physical adsorption takes place between any kind of adsorbate and any kind of adsorbent, irrespective of their nature. There is no any specificity. But on the other hand, chemical adsorption is highly specific in nature. Means chemical adsorption takes place only with a particular type of adsorbate and adsorbent. Okay, well, so what is the difference, second difference here? So physisorption is not specific in nature, while chemisorption is highly specific in nature, is the second point of difference. Well, coming to the next point, so physisorption is reversible in nature. Yen idu reversible andre, say we know adsorption and desorption, right? Andre physisorption aitandre, physisorption now we can subject it for desorption. ಈಗ ಇದು ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಸೇ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್. ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಡಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬೇಟ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬೆಂಟ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅವೆಲ್ಲನ ನಾವು ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ತೆಗಿಬಹುದು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಡಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಮೂವಲ್ ಆಫ್ adsorbates from the surface of a adsorbent is called desorption. So physisorption is reversible in nature, means here desorption is possible. Okay, desorption is possible. On the other hand, if I consider chemisorption, chemisorption is irreversible in nature. Irreversible andre, once okay adsorbates are accumulated on the surface of adsorbent, it is very difficult to remove those from its surface. Therefore, we say it is irreversible in nature, is the next difference. Okay, well, coming to the next point of difference, say enthalpy of adsorption, andre during physisorption what happens, enthalpy decreases, yes or no? That enthalpy of adsorption is low. What is the range? It is in the range of 20 to 40 kilojoules per mole. Okay, during physisorption, whatever enthalpy change, enthalpy decreases, is in the range of what? It is in the range of 20 to 40 kilojoules per mole. Well, on the other hand, chemisorption, what is the enthalpy of adsorption? Since it involves a chemical bond formation, therefore enthalpy adsorption is very high. What is the range? 80 to 240 kilojoules per mole. Okay, please remember the values. Physisorption, enthalpy of adsorption is low, range 20 to 40 kilojoules per mole. Chemisorption, enthalpy of adsorption is high, range okay 80 to 240 kilojoules per mole. Well, next. Now, if I consider Fizzy's option is feasible, or I can say which temperature is favorable for Fizzy's option means a low temperature is favorable. Okay, it takes place or it occurs at a low temperature, or I can say low temperature is favorable for Fizzy's option, and it decreases with the increase in temperature. Andre Fizzy's option decreases with increase in temperature. So if I think of graphically, say Fizzy's absorption and temperature, okay, how they are related? Both are inversely related. It occurs at very low temperature, right? Fizzy's absorption is feasible at low temperature, and usually it decreases. Fizzy's absorption decreases with increase in the temperature, right? Are getting graphically how I can show is the nature of a graph, okay? So it is favorable at low temperature, and it decreases. Fizzy's absorption decreases with increase in the temperature. So it is the nature of a graph. Well, on the other hand, if I consider Fizzy's absorption, high temperature is feasible. High temperature is favorable. So Fizzy's absorption usually occurs at high temperature. Yes. What is the reason for this? Why high temperature is feasible means, since Fizzy's absorption involves bond formation. ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಕೆಮಿಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ಐದರ್ ಅಯಾನಿಕ್ ಆರ್ ಕೋವೆಲೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬೇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬೆಂಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ರೈಟ್ Therefore, what happens initially during chemisorption, some part of the energy is used, part of the energy used to make a bond. Therefore, initially what happens? If we increase the temperature, chemisorption also increases. Thereafter, as usual, again, chemisorption also decreases with the increase in temperature. So here, whatever the statement made, it increases with increase of temperature. It is up to half. Okay, say generally chemisorption, what we are saying, chemisorption increases with the increase in temperature. Okay, increases, why it increases? Initially it increases means, since it involves a bond formation, for the bond formation energy is required. The with increase in temperature means applied heat energy is used to make a bond between adsorbate and adsorbent. Therefore, initially chemisorption increases with increase in temperature. Thereafter, again, usually decreases with the increase in temperature. Okay, well, next point of difference, say fissorption and chemisorption, if I consider which is weak and which is strong, means yes, fissorption is a weak absorption and chemisorption is a strong adsorption. Here meaning weak and strong. Why we are saying weak and strong means, it is because of a type of force operating in between adsorbate and adsorbent. So in fissorption, what type of force exists? It is a weak van der Waals force. Therefore, it is named as a weak adsorption. In chemisorption, a strong chemical bond is formed, hence it is named as a stronger adsorption. Well, and one more difference. So Fizzy's absorption increases with the increase of pressure of adsorbate gas, and finally reaches a limiting value. Means if I consider effect of pressure on physical adsorption, if you increase the pressure, what happens? If you increase the pressure, adsorption also goes on increases, and it reaches finally a limiting value. Beyond, there is no any rise in the adsorption or change in the adsorption. Okay, so remember, consider effect of pressure. Yes, if you increase the pressure, physical adsorption goes on increases, and it reaches a certain final limiting value. Okay, well, on the other hand, chemisorption, pressure of adsorbate has negligible effect. Andre chemisorption consider madidre pressure has no effect on, pressure has no effect on chemical adsorption, right? Or you can say it has very low effect or negligible effect on chemical adsorption. It's the nature of a graph. So it's the one more difference. Next point of difference, what I can say, so physical adsorption here, since it is a weak forces are operating between adsorbate and adsorbent, hence no appreciable activation energy is needed. So I can say here the activation energy is not needed for what? Physical adsorption. But on the other hand, chemical adsorption requires a high activation energy. Okay, it chemical adsorption proceeds with the high activation energy, but physical adsorption, here activation energy is not needed. Okay, well, and regarding physical adsorption results into multi-molecular layers, means say if it is the adsorbent, now there will be formation of a, say it is a one layer of adsorbate, is the second layer of adsorbent, as like, so overall what we are saying, it is a multi-layer. Okay, if I consider, okay, physical adsorption, it is a multi-layers are formed, first, second and third, multi-layer of adsorbates are formed on the surface of a adsorbent. Well, so if I consider it is the adsorbent, on the surface of an adsorbent, a layer, two or three layer of adsorbate molecules are get accumulated. Therefore, we call it is a multi-layer process. On the other hand, if I consider chemical adsorption, say it is the adsorbent, okay? On the surface of adsorbent, what happens? Whether is there for, here also function of multilayer? No. Okay. Here only a layer of adsorbate. There will be only one layer of adsorbates are accumulated on the surface of a adsorbent. Means during chemical adsorption only, how many layers are formed? There will be formation of only one layer. Therefore, we call it is a unimolecular layer. Only one layer of adsorbates are present. But in physisorption, what happens? Two or three layer of adsorbates may be present. So it's regarding differences between physisorption and chemisorption. I hope it's clear for you. Then please remember, a physical adsorption is carried out at low temperature. A physical adsorption at low temperature may pass into chemical adsorption. Andre, say we have adsorption channel, it is a physical adsorption which is carried out at low temperature. If you increase the temperature, what happens? A physical adsorption may convert into chemical adsorption. Okay, then pitkodi, a physical adsorption at low temperature may pass into chemical adsorption as the temperature is increased, right? So if you increase the temperature, physical adsorption may convert it into chemical adsorption. Means those weak van der Waals forces of attractions are replaced by strong chemical forces of attraction in the form of either ionic bond or a covalent bond. Okay, well, then coming to the MCQs. Well, the first one, what is the first MCQ? Just go through that. What it says, adsorption occurs due to weak van der Waals forces. And really, adsorption aagtide. If adsorption occurs due to what type of forces of attraction? Weak van der Waals forces of attraction. Then it is known as, adi yavudu adsorption anta kelthidare. Physisorption, second chemisorption, C both, and fourth one none of these. Yes, what is the answer? Physisorption. Yen helidim now? a type of adsorption which adsorbate and adsorbents are held together by means of weak van der Waals forces of attraction. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಈಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ವೆಲ್, ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್, ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್. ಈಗ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೋ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಸೇ ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಥರ್ಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್, ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಂಟ್. ಹೇಳಲ್ವಾ ಏನು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ, ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವೇನ್ ಹೇಳಿದೀವಿ, ವೀಕ್ ವಾನ್ ಡೆರ್ ವಾಲ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್, ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಲೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಮಲ್ಟಿಲೇಯರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್, ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹೀಗೆಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ರ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಹೇಳಿದೀವಿ ನಾವು. ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದೆಮ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ದ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ನಾವೇನ್ ಹೇಳಿದೀವಿ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ, ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೋ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿವಿ. ಹೌದಾ, ಲೋ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ಇದೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೇಂಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 20-40 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ, 80-240 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ವೆಲ್, ವಿ ಲುಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಏನಿದೆ, 20-40 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, 80-240 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಥರ್ಡ್, 40-80 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್, ನನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್. ಏನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ, ದ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್ 20-40 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್. ರೈಟ್, ವೆಲ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ದ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಆಫ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಿಜಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಇವಾಗ ಏನಿದೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನೋಡೋಣ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ 20-40, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ 80-240, ಥರ್ಡ್ 40-80, ಅಂಡ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ನನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್. ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಏನಿದಕ್ಕೆ, 80-240 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ರೈಟ್, ವೆಲ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಈಗ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಯಾವ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಫಾರ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ವೆಲ್, ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಏನಿದೆ ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ಇರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ನೀಡ್ ಹೈ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಮೊನೋಲೇಯರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್. ಈಗ ರಾಂಗ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕಂಡಿಡಬೇಕು ನಾವು. ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ಮೊನೋಲೇಯರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ರಾಂಗ್? ಎಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಪ್ಷನ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಮೊನೋಲೇಯರ್ ಯುನಿಲೇಯರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಆರ್ ಇರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್, ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಸೊ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಹೈ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಶನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಏನಿದೆ ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಈಗ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಆ ಇರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇದೆ, ಇರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿವಿ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಾಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿ, ರಿವರ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ರಾಂಗ್ ಇದೆ, ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್, ಈ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಗೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಏನು, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ವೆಲ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ದ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.